nowadays. See, ESM Narasimhanji, Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri N. Chandrababu Naiduji, Union Minister for Civil Aviation, Sri Gajapati Rajuji, Sri N. Chinna Rajappa, Deputy Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Sri Hari Babu, Member of Parliament, other ministers of government of Andhra Pradesh, and distinguished guests on the dais, Vice Chancellor of Andhra Pradesh University, Professor Nageshwar Rao, members of the faculty and staff, dear students, ladies and gentlemen. This is my first visit to Visakhapatnam since assuming the office as the President of India. I am glad it has brought me to this well-known and well-respected institution of higher learning, Andhra University. It has a proud legacy in our country. Our second President and my distinguished predecessor, the scholar and academic Dr. S. Radhakrishnan, was the second Vice Chancellor of this university. I am also happy to note that the alumni of Andhra University include the current Vice President of our country, Sri M. Venkaiah Naidu, as well as other senior judges, technologists and corporate leaders. In coming here, therefore, I am paying my tribute to the rich intellectual heritage of the university and of the state of Andhra Pradesh. My visit here will mark three milestones. Number one, opening of the Center for Defense Studies, Andhra University. Number two, laying of the foundation stone for the E-classroom complex and incubation center of the Department of Computer Science and Systems Engineering, Andhra University College of Engineering. And number three, inauguration of the classroom and laboratory complex at Andhra University College of Engineering for women. While these three achievements and institutions are different, there is a common thread. The link is in Andhra University's commitment to cutting-edge technologies, their inclusive availability, and their application in fields of public and strategic importance. I am happy to learn that the Andhra University Defense Joint Education and Research Program is a distinctive effort for any state university in our country. I have been told that the Chief of our Air Force visited this university recently, and his visit provided a major boost to the Andhra University Defense Joint Education and Research Center. It is extremely satisfying that the university, in particular its College of Engineering, is engaged in R&D projects with defense institutions. I understand that the Center for Defense Studies will focus on cybersecurity, nanotechnology, radar and communications, corrosion technology, and other technologies that have strategic dimensions. Professors and researchers from this university are collaborating on this specific projects with DRDO as well as with the Naval Research Board and other institutions. Professors from Andhra University have been used as R&D consultants for missile projects, including in the development of Brahmosmissile. Additionally, expertise from this university has been sought by the Eastern Naval Command, here headquartered here in Visakhapatnam, for civil engineering structural applications and corrosion related issues. This is indeed an impressive body of work. Research related to defense and military applications and technologies will have multiple benefits for our country. It will provide a tonic to the effort to make in India and to innovate, develop and manufacture military technology and equipment. And as experience in other countries has shown, research and defense technologies can also lead to innovations that have diverse civilian applications. For example, the internet, advances in information technology and the development of space technologies have changed human society. All of these have either originated in or been accelerated by research in defense technologies. I am confident that will be the root in India as well, and that this university will be an important engine in this journey. The Department of Computer Science and Systems Engineering will also have a role to play in this endeavor. I understand it is one of the largest departments in the university with over 1200 students. The inauguration of the e-classroom complex and incubation center will enhance the department's capacity to innovate and provide solutions for our country's needs in socio-economic development and defense alike. In fact, I must commend the efforts of the government of Andhra Pradesh, led by the Chief Minister, Shri Naidu ji. It is promoting and using technology for the benefit of common people in fields as far apart as urban planning and agriculture. Ladies and gentlemen, the overall gender imbalance in our scientific and technological institutions continues to be a concern. In this context, I am happy to note that 40% of the students at this university are girls. I am fully optimistic that the inauguration of the classroom and laboratory complex at the Andhra University College of Engineering for Women will enhance our country's capacities to produce high quality women engineers and technologists. A true test of India's progress is in the access and opportunities we provide to our daughters when it comes to education. I must point out here that some of our leading defense and space scientists who have powered our missile programs and our rocket launches are women. Earlier this week, at a university convocation in Agra, Uttar Pradesh, I was privileged to felicitate the senior DRDO scientist, Dr. Tessie Thomas, known as the Missile Women of India. Women achievers like her are role models for our youth, particularly for our girl students. With these words, I wish Andhra University and wish all of you the very best for the future. May the university continue to be a technology hub for our country, and may its technologists, both men and women, continue to help in the building of our defense research capacities. Thank you. Jai.